So as you guys know, we've been studying volume. So what is volume again?
Volume is the space within a 3D shape.
My name's Betsy Hustler. I am a grade 4-5 teacher at Ross Park Primary in Alice Springs. We're a school with a lot of different cultures and a mixture of different students from different places. I select and use resources that cater for a lot of the learning needs of my class. I've noticed that a lot of the kids can pick things up a lot easier if they're able to build something and then visualise how it is after it's been built. The mathematical outcomes that I'd like to achieve in this lesson is that children are able to work out the formula for volume. So our scenario is that Mrs. Blanchfield has asked us to provide her with 6 cubic metres of balloons for the spring fair. All right, so how do you think that we'd work this out? Ruby?
We could make a cubic metre.
The resources that I've chosen will be the group task role cards. I think that they're really important to have an allocated role for the children to make sure that there's accountability for one and everyone knows that they've got something that they need to be doing and they need to be taking ownership of. What's your job, Nathan?
I am a leader.
You're a leader. Wow, what do leaders usually do? After that, I'll be explaining the resources to them, so I've provided them with some newspapers, which I'm expecting that they'll roll up to make their cubic metre. I've given them straws, they're going to have 1 metre ruler, and there's going to be some sticky tape and some cellophane, and they will be problem solving together to decide how they can construct this cubic metre with things that aren't actually a metre long. So it will be a challenge for them, and they'll have to problem solve on the way.
All right, now we just need 2 more poles, so then we can get the top.
Need some help.
Are we making it so like it's a box, like you can go inside of?
Okay, well, we should use cellophane.
We will use cellophane. Write that down.
The best thing I find having the iPads in the class as a teacher is it gives me some anecdotal evidence to actually see afterwards. I'm not there for all of the conversations with the children and how they constructed their things. So I can collect in the iPads and then I can sort of reflect and assess based on what I've seen in there. It's always good to assess the kids not just on a addition algorithm or something like that. It's the thought processes that went behind everything rather than just the finished product.
Well, I reckon we should use the bamboo sticks because they would be really good for support.
We could use the 4 at the bottom and then use 1 to go to the top so we know how high to make everything else.
The next step with me as a teacher is using the resources that we've actually made as a classroom. What we'll do tomorrow or maybe the next day is we'll use our cubic metres and we'll discuss how many cubic metres might fit in this classroom and work it out based on my actual hands-on learning. We know that there are how many balloons in 1 cubic metre by working out the volume?
You times 100 by 6 and that's 600, then you times the 25 by 6 and that's 150.
I think the kids' understanding with maths went really well today. It wasn't just addressing the formula that we needed for volume. It was also assessing what materials they were going to use to make 1 metre, and how they were going to use these informal tools to actually make what they needed to make. I feel that having really hands-on, exciting activities really makes kids want to come to school. Something that seems quite small for you is a really big deal for the kids and they really look forward to actually doing it and working with their friends and having a good time.
What is the value of providing students with a range of resources for learning? In what ways have you used ICT to engage students in their learning? What classroom management strategies are important in order to have effective collaborative learning?